This young queen has successfully raised her first daughters beneath the leaf litter of the rainforest floor. The nutritious fungus she fed them as larvae is now dwindling. If they don't find food quickly, they will all starve. Unfortunately for the ants, overgrown swarms of parasitic phorid flies are beginning to hatch. Leafcutter innards provide perfect incubation chambers for the young of these insidious insects. The small scouting party of minor workers could lead any number of deadly jungle creatures back to their undefended queen. They will need time and luck on their side. The workers have located a patch of young seedlings, just what they were looking for. The leaves are soft enough to be sliced up with ease and carried back to the nest. The harvested leaf chunks are not eaten directly. Instead, they are used by the very smallest minim workers to cultivate a nutritious fungus. Over time, waste builds up in the fungus gardens, and if left unchecked, it can attract necrotrophic parasites. To deal with this problem, Atacephalotis dig out subterranean waste heaps, preferably as far as possible from the healthy nursery chambers. The ants' activities outside the nest have not gone unnoticed. They are being watched. These rove beetle larvae are distant relatives of the European devil's coach horse. Despite a few million years of separation, they share the same carnivorous appetite, razor-sharp pincers, and most importantly, a fearsome final form. The most accessible leaves are located to the north of the nest entrance. However, another Atta colony has already laid claim to them. The close proximity of these nests places the two colonies in direct competition with one another. Time will tell which has the potential to grow into a great empire, and which will submit to the unforgiving law of the Undergrowth. As the sun sets below the horizon, and the thick rainforest canopy shrouds all but the slightest glimmer of moonlight, the predators of the night begin to emerge. One of the ants has fallen prey to a young, leaf-mimic praying mantis. Once in range, its long, razor-clad forelegs can ensnare and impale victims with lightning speed. Daybreak has arrived, and the creatures of the night scurry back to the dark crevices of the undergrowth. For the ants, however, the objectives of the day remain unchanged. Locate vegetation, defend supply lines, and process leaves. There is no time for rest. A young velvet worm, Oroperipatis ecuadoriensis, is lurking over ground. These ancient mysterious predators are masters of ambush. They creep toward their unwitting victims silently on soft, hollow legs. Once in range, they squirt oscillating streams of slime, forming a wide net that entraps their prey. The workers have done all they can to improve this refuse dump. The workers have done all they can to improve these leaf stores.
The battle has begun.
A brightly patterned jumping spider, Secasviri D. purpureus, has subdued one of the workers. This expert solo hunter combines extreme agility with incredible forward vision, allowing it to pounce on unsuspecting prey with pinpoint accuracy. Leafcutters aren't the only ants nearby. Whilst the two Atta colonies joust for territory, Odontomachus bowri trap jaws roam the clearing. They can be found hunting alone or in small packs for vulnerable invertebrates to take back to their nest. They use snapping jaws to bludgeon their targets, exerting 300 times their body weight in a single blow. Phorid flies are attempting to lay eggs into the heads of ants on the foraging trail. Those traveling towards the leaves can defend themselves. Those lumbered with cargo will need assistance. The ants will fight to the death. The battle has begun. Night falls, and under the cloak of darkness, velvet worms, bush crickets, and harvestmen emerge from their hiding places. Any ant straying from the relative safety of the trail will likely meet with an unfortunate end. Phorid flies are attempting to lay eggs into the heads of ants on the foraging trail. Those traveling towards the leaves can defend themselves. Those lumbered with cargo will need assistance. The workers have done all they can to improve this refuse dump. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected. The leafcutters have raised their first major ant. Its swollen head is filled with muscle to power its crushing jaws. Few stand against it in combat and escape unscathed. This champion warrior will make a fine addition to the colony. An ant has fallen prey to a wandering harvestman. Its long, slender legs keep its vulnerable body elevated high above the leaf litter. And when threatened, it can release strong-smelling odors to deter other predators. A stern response will be needed to drive this striding nuisance away. Phorid flies are attempting to lay eggs into the heads of ants on the foraging trail. Those traveling towards the leaves can defend themselves. Those lumbered with cargo will need assistance. The ants must defend themselves. Phorid flies are attempting to lay eggs into the heads of ants on the foraging trail. Those traveling towards the leaves can defend themselves. Those lumbered with cargo will need assistance. As the sun rises over the treetops above, the diurnal jungle invertebrates emerge once again to replace their nighttime counterparts. The ants will remain steadfast in their efforts. All must be risked for the harvest. Phorid flies are attempting to lay eggs into the heads of ants on the foraging trail. Those traveling towards the leaves can defend themselves. Those lumbered with cargo will need assistance. Phorid flies are attempting to lay eggs into the heads of ants on the foraging trail. Those traveling towards the leaves can defend themselves. Those lumbered with cargo will need assistance. The ants must defend themselves. The ants must fight. The hillside Atta colony is falling behind. With their demise at hand, they have no choice but to strike back at their opponent. The ants must fight. Phorid flies are attempting to lay eggs into the heads of ants on the foraging trail. Those traveling towards the leaves can defend themselves. Those lumbered with cargo will need assistance. The battle has begun. The ants have subdued their rivals and achieved dominion over the clearing. As the competition withers, they will extend their territory in all directions, firmly establishing their agricultural empire. One day, this colony will number in the millions.